Hi everyone, and welcome back to my BB is Belle channel. Glad to see you again and see that you are coming back to my wonderful content. So today's video is going to be maybe a bit juicier than the ones before, so just saying, maybe if you're under a teen, I would advise for you to not watch today's content. So today on the menu, we're going to talk about rockstar fandoms, I guess we can call them like that. We're going to talk especially about the fan fictions community, because there's just stuff out there that's hilarious, and I really wanted to talk about some of the great creators who write some of these fan fictions. I don't feel bad if you write fan fiction, or we're not here to laugh at you, we're here to laugh with you, I guess. I'm not saying that what you do is cringe, I'm really not here to shame anybody, but I just thought it would be funny and interesting to talk about how a lot of rock stars, whether it's from the 60s, 70s, or the 80s, maybe even 90s again, are still really popular to the point that they have entire fandom communities writing fan fictions, whatever. All types of fantasies are out there, and I thought it could be funny for today's video to just dive into some of them out there. We're going to talk about especially Guns N' Roses, we're going to talk about Motley Crue. These are the main two that I've been following in the past couple of years, but I know that Metallica, Megadeth fanfiction world is doing absolutely well right now. It's just thriving like never before, and it's been like that for quite a couple of years, really, because when I was really into the world of fan fictions, because yes, I am myself a proud mother of a couple of fan fictions, but we're not gonna talk about that. We're just gonna jump over that for today. But yeah, so let's see what I come up with. So I suppose there are sort of two categories I could come up with here. Because we have what we could say is the most, I don't know if that's the most popular, or at least it's my current favorite. It's, okay, so I found the term I was looking for. I guess it's reader X, whoever you're looking up. So this is my personal favorite in terms of fan fictions. But there's also what we could call the second category that I know is very popular, because I am guilty too of taking part in this kind of trend. So these are when you ship two band members together. I'm gonna talk about the rock star that are men, because I haven't followed any fandom with where the stars were female. So if that's your world, I'm sorry, but I'm not gonna talk about that. So the community I've been the most familiar with recently is the Izzy Stradlin fanfiction community of Tumblr. I mean, just see for yourself. But I've gotta say, on Tumblr, anything labeled as Guns N' Roses is pretty juicy, no matter the band member. We've got Axel, we've got Slash, Duff, we got a lot of Easy, even Steven Adler. I don't know about the new band members, it was Gilby Clark that replaced Easy. I think the fictions exist, I have not really seen them. The main one that everybody's crushing over is classic GNR, so the classic lineup I just said. So already the first thing we see when you go into the hashtag Izzy Stradlin fic on Tumblr, so this is from somebody's account called 50s 80s man, girl I feel you. I'd kill for a threesome with Nikki and Izzy. I'd also kill for a threesome with Nikki and Tommy as well. So this is what I was talking about. Motley Crue, Guns N' Roses, just thriving out there. So just with Mr. Izzy Stradlin here, we already have so much like genre this available to us. We got some fluff stuff, like some Christmas stories. We have some hurt comfort stuff with warnings such as language, drug mentions. What else have we got? We got some wedding story. Some stories where your Duff's little sister Izzy Stradlin becoming a father. So girls that are just dreaming of having Mr. Stradlin's baby. What else? Oh my lord. We got handcuffed Izzy Stradlin. Oh lord. So warning, profanities, sexual content. And you have a lot of these accounts also that accept some requests, so if it's something you love, absolutely go see them. I'm sure they would be happy to write you a story. There's so many of those, and honestly a lot of these fictions are really good. I'm guilty because I have read a few of those, but again, we're just not gonna talk about that too much. But yeah, so definitely recommend a lot of these accounts if that's something you love. There's so much different styles. So this is just on Tumblr, and this is just Izzy Stradlin. Let's see what else I can find. So wait, just one more. This was somebody's request, and it's too gold for me not to read this to y'all. So, hey, could you write something about current Izzy chasing his breath? Not gonna say anything else. Around the house because she smacked him on the ass after he was already grumpy. And whatever he does after that is up to you. And so in the Nikki 6 tags, and already this is what we see. I mean, with the tag DILF alert, girl, it just speaks for itself. What else have we got? I guess Nikki was sort of, well, not encouraging this sort of stereotype about himself, but as you can see here, he's, I don't know what's the word. So there we go, I just found it. So we have here just, already it didn't take very long for me to find some weird stuff. So we have some Nikki 6 vampire fantasy. Yeah, Nikki 6 x human reader, and it says NSFW, kind of like this video. Biting, blood, sex, vampire sex. So no pregnancy chances. Wow, okay. But yeah, when I say there's really all type of fantasies out there, we are not done. We're definitely not going to cover everything, but this is just an example. I've seen a lot of those with Motley Crue members where they are vampires, werewolves, so many things. And I guess it's because the Motley Crue's appearance, but people have like, or girls, whatever, have a tendency to picture them as all these things. I've also seen Motley Crue pirates. It was kind of good, but my current favorite with pirates would be AC/DC as pirates. But this is, I'm just gonna shut up. So one last Nikki post, I mean, I had to put this in there, that's just it. Moving on to AC/DC now, I wanted to talk about it because they're my current favorite, but yes, they don't have much of a big community out there, unfortunately. AC/DC, they're not as popular as the previous bands I've mentioned, but I mean, there's a couple of really fun fictions out there. Shout out to you, groupie whore. Sorry. Who wrote A Whole Lot of Woman. Thank you. Just thank you. But yeah, we have some AC/DC headcanons. NSFW. I don't know if I need to say more. Yeah. So basically just describes how your favorite band member would do certain things to you. Next one, and I have to describe this one because this is a confession. And, you know, I cringe so bad that I have to share this because, oh my god, you know. I wonder if Angus Young and Bon Scott ever got... I can't say it. You read it. I feel like I need holy water after reading this. Yes, police. I gotta call the police. Yes. Just no for this one. I'm so sorry, but this is a no from me. Hell no. Oh my god, it just got worse. Jim Morrison is so unbelievably daddy. There's a lot of... I just saw a couple of posts talking about it. Yeah, one of the big popular ships, we're gonna call it like that, is John Lennon and Paul McCartney. All the people that... worship them together, saying they maybe had more than a friendship experience. So yeah, that's a big popular one. But moving on, I just saw this and man, this is gold. I mean, it's hilarious. There's this pic of Lars Ulrich and Ian Paice. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. I keep in my wallet, and while I'm up late at night, I fantasize about having a threesome with them. I did not expect the end of this one. I mean, that how the sentence would end like this. Girl. I want to lick Jimmy Page like an ice cream cone. It just... I'm gasping. Yeah, shout out to Dad Rock Confessions. I've just found this account and there's such gold. So gold. God. Girl, this is a hell no. This is a hell no. This is not a one that needs to be burned to the ground. Hell no, girl. What the hell is that? Some foot fetish people. I know, I'm not trying to judge, but my goodness. I'm going down a rabbit hole that I just didn't expect when I started this video. This one has got to be a lie. Like, this is a troll. Like, this cannot be true. Come on. Like, David Lee Roth is my future husband. And I'm saving my virginity for him. Wait, this is not over. A guy I'm seeing at the moment thinks I'm joking whenever I tell him I'm saving myself. But I quickly realize I'm not. What? A lot of threesome stuff here we have. I really want to get high at ASF and have a threesome with Tony Iommi and Richie Blackmore. I didn't expect that. Shall I make my personal threesome confession right now in this moment? Oh, I guess I could. Well, okay, I thought about a threesome with... God. Z Stradlin and Bon Scott. Yeah. I don't know how proud of myself I need to be. Going back to Metallica here, at least because I mentioned them at the beginning of this video, so I didn't want to let you down and think that I was not going to talk about them, but just quickly. So yeah, I used to be, I don't know how ashamed of this I should be, but I used to be a big fan of the ship, James Hetfield and Lars Ulrich. Yes, I know, but yeah, so I'm just going to get over that, but yeah, already... I just wrote Metallica fix on Tumblr. Already found it. Jamie with pregnant reader. So I guess this is a fic about having a baby with James Hetfield. God, Lord. I have just found, speaking of threesomes again, a threesome smut with Slash and Kirk Hammett. Do I need to say more? This is funny as hell, somebody commenting, there's a serious lack of Kirk Hammett fix. I swear I'm about to start writing some of my own self, some for my own self-indulgence. This man needs to be appreciated. Girl, yeah, you do you, I guess. But it's just funny, I'm personally not that big into Kirk Hammett. But I can see why his fans are into him, for sure. A to Z, NSFW, Lars Ulrich. I'm not the guy to have fantasies about Lars, but already the first sentence is, Lars is a fucking hottie, and if you disagree, then we will fight. Oh my goodness, this is hilarious. So moving on to Megadeth, as you can imagine, this is mostly Dave Mustaine smut. You know. But I just found this really cursed, really cursed post following the heavy metal tag. So I can see Dave Mustaine, ex-pregnant reader, / James Hetfield leaving the pregnant reader fix. Always amazing. I mean, just always coming up with things that I absolutely never, ever expected. Alright, I think this video's lasted for way longer than I expected again. This just keeps happening. But yeah, if there's more, you want me to do more content like this and react to more, we're gonna say fanfic kind of posts, just let me know in the comments. I will be very happy to go hunt for more crazy stuff just for you and react if you want to send me some, not requests, but if there's posts you want me to react to, you can send them in my DMs on my Instagram, which is BB from the North. I'm very active on there, and it's very different from my YouTube, but yeah, I think it's worth giving it a shot if you like passion music. I post more of my personal stuff, but. And so lastly, shout out to my sponsor, which is Lauson Jewelry. So Lauson does a lot of necklaces, earrings, and bracelets, and all sorts of that kind of things. If there's something you like, you can have 50% off using my code BBISBELL. So definitely check that out. And there's also a link in my description for 30% off Lauson Jewelry.